Hey, everybody. Hope you are doing well. One of the great debut albums in the rock world was Living Color's debut album, Vivid, back in, I believe, 1989. It came on with an absolute sledgehammer strike with a song called A Personality, followed up by other really thought-provoking songs like Open Letter to a Landlord and even the song Glamour Boys. This is a lesser played track on that album, but still equally as powerful. It's a song called Desperate People. We'll talk more about the album when we're done with the song. Okay, so let's play the song Desperate People by Living Color. I don't know if it can be overestimated how important the Living Color album is, the debut album by Living Color is. It was really, really critical in many ways. It was a door opener for black artists in the hard rock and heavy metal genre, opening the doors for bands like Korn and Rage Against the Machine and others. It also opened the door for people to get much more message-based in their writing and lyrics. Amazingly enough, a lot of music prior to this was just really, you know, sort of fluff, if you will, lyrically. A lot of sex, drugs, and rock and roll, and again, fun musical lyrics, but not really too many in the hard rock metal world that made you think super deeply. You know, you had artists like Megadeth that were talking about some deeper, relevant conversations. You had some other artists, but really it was few and far between. So what you have here is an album that not only talked about some racist-tinged criticism, obviously inequality, economical instability, critiquing politics and capitalism, slumlords, and with songs like Glamour Boys, really the fake nature of plastic people and people living on credit rather than actual financial stability. And with a song like this, it's sort of saying, you know, it's sort of critiquing people who, you know, have the ability to ignore, unfair practices. You know, they don't necessarily see the racial inequality. They don't necessarily see the economic inequality that's going on out there. And they're just oblivious to it because they're living their own lives and they're not really paying that much attention to the state of the world for other people around them. And therefore, they're not really practicing empathy. It's not even necessarily that they're bad people. It's just they're not awake to a broader spectrum of reality. And so, again, it's really important that this band showed that you could criticize and critique the world around you to sort of, you know, not necessarily, basically it's a fight for change. It's an attempt at opening the eyes of people who otherwise would just be going about their lives and not really paying attention to things. But then they hear a song like Cult of Personality and they listen to the lyrics and they go, oh, wow, well, that's deeper. Or Open Letter to a Landlord, you know, talking about slumlords and what have you. And they go, oh, whoa, there's a whole different world out there that I am unaware of in my comfortable suburban lifestyle. And again, I can't emphasize, in my opinion, how important this album was and how groundbreaking it was by comparison to so much other stuff that was out there in 1989 when this came out. I mean, you know, think about it. What was out there? You know, what musically was out there in 1989? Not really the deepest thinking hard rock and metal, you know. It was kind of the height of hair metal at that time. It was pre-grunge. And, you know, mostly the record industry was pushing people toward in hard rock bands to create power ballads because, you know, songs like Every Rose Has Its Thorn and, others, you know, Europe's Carrie, plenty of stuff by Bon Jovi were really shooting up the charts, you know, and so it pushed a lot of bands, a lot of hard rock bands to their, honestly, to their detriment, into making sure that they had a power ballad out there for people to, you know, sing along with. And Living Color comes along and says, no, 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 we're going to talk about, you know, injustices. That's what we're going to do. And you're going to pay attention because we can write one hell of a song. We're killer players. And we're going to put out very strong video content in, you know, songs like Cult of Personality with the use of Malcolm X and Martin Luther King you know, JFK and Franklin Roosevelt audio clips mixed into the song, and people are going to listen. And they were right. Living Color was very much right. Anyway, with that said, hope you appreciated this. Hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below and know that I appreciate you. Love to talk to you further about it and what you think. Know that I appreciate you and I wish you all well. Okay, take care.